A ferry from India to Sri Lanka is completing its first voyage, re-establishing link that had been broken since 1983 and strengthening economic links between the people of the two countries. The ferry, Scotia Prince, was flagged off on Monday from India's Tuticorin port on a 14-hour journey to Sri Lanka's capital, Colombo. The vessel, which will travel twice weekly on Wednesdays and Fridays, has a capacity of 1,040 passengers. The ferry allows baggage for up to 100 kilograms per person, as well as another 100 kilograms at a lower cost compared to air travelers.
It signifies resumption of traditional linkages connecting peoples of India and Sri Lanka. We enjoy extremely close and cordial relations between our two countries. It's a relationship which is based on contacts between peoples. And today, through resumption of ferry service, we are reinforcing these traditional links. I believe the ferry service between Colombo and Tuticorin will make it easier for ordinary people, whether they be pilgrims or business people or ordinary tourists, to travel between our two countries. And with more travel, with more links, with greater exchanges, with greater contacts, strong and cordial links that we enjoy between our two countries is bound to become even stronger. I have no doubt about it.
Trade barriers have been relaxed since the mid-1990s, but obstacles to voluntary exchanges between Indians and Sri Lankans remain. Sri Lanka has also freed visa restrictions to India, making it the largest generating market to the country's tourist industry. Indian visitors in particular benefit the small and medium end of the leisure and restaurant sector, broadening inclusive growth rather than being limited to the high end as with travellers from industrialised nations.
Before too long, we'll be able to start ferry service between Rameshwaram and Thalaimannar as well. That will require rehabilitation of pier and some of the facilities at two ends, but our two governments are committed to doing that, and I'm quite confident that before too long we'll have that ferry service in place as well.
The darkest and one of the longest lunar eclipses in the century will be visible in Sri Lankan skies tomorrow, Arthur C. Clarke Institute said. The eclipse begins at 10:55 p.m. tomorrow night, with the moon entering into the penumbra of the Earth's shadow, and will end up at 4:31 a.m. According to Astronomical Association, the eclipse is expected to last around 100 minutes. More than 15 full-length films from around the world will make their Sri Lankan debut at the Kandy International Film Festival, which is scheduled to be held from 22nd to the 26th of June. Directors and films from Bangladesh, France, India, Singapore, Thailand and the United States, as well as local features, will be represented at this festival. The five-day film festival will bring international and local award-winning new films for Sri Lankan audiences.
මේ ලෝකයේ බෙදා හැරීමේ ක්‍රමය තුළ ඉතා හොඳ චිත්‍රපටි රාශිය අපට මගහැරෙනවා. ඒ මගහැරෙන්නේ බෙදා හැරීමේ ක්‍රියාවලිය තියෙන්නේ සමාගම් කීපයක් සතු ඇති නිසා ලෝකෙ. ඉතින් ඒ නිසා අපි මේ චිත්‍රපට උළෙලකදී වෙන්නේ අපට නිරන්තරයෙන් බලන්නට නොලැබෙන සිනමා ශාලාවකදී බලන්නට නොලැබෙන සමහර වෙලාවට ටිකක් DVD සංයුක්ත දැක්කියත් හොයාගන්න අමාරු චිත්‍රපටියක් අපට බලන්නට හම්බුනේ. ඉතින් ඒ අවස්ථාවේ අද මේ වෙනකොට චිත්‍රපටයේ උළෙලවල් කියන්නේ එක්තරා ආකාරයක විකල්ප බෙදා හැරීමේ ක්‍රමයක්. අපි කියන්නේ ඒල්ටර්නටිව් ඩිස්ට්‍රිබියුෂන් සිස්ටම්.
Samsung Electronics launched its new smart TV to the Sri Lankan market with anticipations to reach the status of market leader in the flat panel television category by end this year.
We have made a significant progress in this market, have strengthened our business to a great extent to have set up our branch office here in Colombo. I'm pleased to say that we are now the market leader in the smartphone and touchscreen mobile phone segment in Sri Lanka. We have already gained significant market share in the flat panel television category, and based on the new 2011 smart television lineup that we are launching today, I'm confident that we can become the market leader in flat panel television category in this market very soon. As a global leader in flat panel television, we were the first to launch LED TVs in the year 2009 and 3D TVs in the year 2010. This year, we have again taken the lead by introducing smart television to consumers all over the world and in Sri Lanka as well.
The Met Department says there will be showers at several places in the western, Sabaragamuwa and central provinces and in the Galle and Mathura districts. Fairly strong southwesterly winds are likely along the western slopes of the central hills. Eastern, southeastern and northern sea areas will be fairly rough.
You can now follow Debrief on YouTube, Twitter and Facebook.